Is the future of body armor a big ol' hype train to absolutely nowhere? We'll find out in just a second. But first, get yourself today's top quality body armor by Spartan Armor Systems. They're certified hype train free. First responders, veterans, and active duty service members get 10% off. Click the link in the description to order now. Since the dawn of time, the infantry has always loved their body armor and shields. Heck, you can usually judge how good a soldier is based on how squared away their body armor looks. New body armor, though, is being cut into smaller shooter-style plates. And even those slight adjustments mean that we're shaving valuable pounds off the combat load. But what if there was a better solution to this problem? What if soldiers in the future could carry 300 pounds of body armor and heavy weapons with ease? In this video, we'll cover that workaround called the Exoskeleton Hydraulic Powered Suit. They promised to make heavy body armor a problem of the past. Okay, wait. Is no one going to mention that the soldier in that animation is literally unarmed? Hey, Sergeant, where's your rifle?
I don't know. I definitely didn't leave it in the chow hall. I just felt like I needed to crush some skulls today.
We're also going to look at a new advancement in ballistic t-shirts that's just now rolling out to the line units. So, the US Special Forces are working on a modern day Iron Man suit called the Tactical Assault Light Operator Suit, Talos. It aims to fully protect soldiers from incoming rounds, and that makes sense because it costs over $1 million for the US military to train each Special Forces soldier. Obviously, it pays to invest in making sure a 7.62 round that costs 30 cents stabbed halfway across the world can't kill your elite forces. The exoskeleton is designed to provide soldiers with 300% greater lift and load carrying capability. If my math is correct, ballistic plates covering your whole body would weigh at least 150 pounds. So, how close are we to achieving this goal? Well, let's look at the Human Universal Load Carrier made by Lockheed Martin. It's the most advanced prototype. The shorter version of the name is Hulk. Yes, you can finally give that order you've been dreaming of. Hulk, go over there and smash that objective. Hua Hulk! It's battery powered as opposed to the Raytheon version, which needed to be tethered by cable or generator. Hulk allows the operator to move at 10 kilometers per hour and up to 20 kilometer range. It should hold its charge for around 24 hour mission, and it provides assistance to the hip and knee joint with actuators. These actuators are told what to do by sensors located on the suit. The sensor relays information to a microcomputer, which in turn moves the hydraulic system to help amplify the operator's movements. So the weight of the load carried is then transferred to the ground through the shoes of the exoskeleton. At this rate, the Hulk was able to provide some reduced metabolic consumption for soldiers, although if you've ever seen a mechanized infantry unit, they're the last people I think that need a reduction in calories. If you want to see more content like this, please remember to hit the like button. So the military then demanded that it needed a battery that was big enough to run a much longer 96-hour mission. The engineers couldn't figure that request out. And so here we get to the problem with all this. We're being fed a big bunch of military hype train here. I found out that all these programs that are promising the sky, they all ended up being canceled recently. The power suit performance enhancements were a huge exaggeration. It turns out that the suit relieves pressure on some muscles, but it offloads all that weight directly to other muscle groups. The result is you end up with more strain overall. We are in the hype phase of these technologies. Hugh Herr, an engineer at MIT, says that the exoskeletons currently out there are little more than fancy exercise machines. So they're basically a $2 million Bowflex. Only 55 easy payments of $500,000. So not to be outdone, the Russians just released footage of their own exoskeleton project. It looks like both teams are in a race here against each other to see who can produce a more campy video. Just watch as they step onto a box in a warehouse. You know, war stuff. Watch as the Russian exoskeleton suit dramatically walks up stairs and enters an unmarked van. This isn't a super soldier demonstration, it's a life alert commercial. Does your Spetsnaz squad have trouble running slowly through a field? Or hopping like a bunny rabbit while on patrol? If so, get your grandpa's edition Red Dawn exoskeleton suit today! The best part is the ending of the video. It's got a bunch of 1990s Matrix-style scrolling data and graphics. If I wasn't afraid of a near-peer fight before, I'm absolutely terrified of it now. I don't want to go up against a bunch of superhuman yoga soldiers. Look at that Russian soldier almost touch their toes. Terrifying! Okay, so this prototype was developed by Rostec as part of the Ratnik program. The Ratnik program is the next generation Russian infantry body armor system, and it's actually really cool. The exoskeleton is made of lightweight carbon fiber. It supports the soldier's back and legs when carrying a pack of up to 110 pounds. According to Russia, the prototype was already tested by their armed forces in real-life combat situations. Rostec said, quote, "The exoskeleton is hidden beneath the clothes and gear. It does not hinder the soldier's movement, but on the contrary, it eases the strain on the locomotor system. It allows for easily carrying up to 60 kilograms of combat equipment and weapons, while it only weighs 6 kilograms on its own." End quote. Fun fact, it was a Russian named Nicholas Yang who invented the first exoskeleton suit back in the 1890s. Take a look at these actual drawings from the real patent. It was based on bags of compressed gas attached to the limbs. And while it didn't work, and this modern day one might not live up to the hype either, it's fascinating to see militaries around the world working to develop this new technology. It's gonna have real world implications for maybe people who've lost their legs. They're gonna have an opportunity now to maybe use these exoskeletons in the future. As a Long Island Italian bro, it'd be awesome to finally be able to say I can lift 200 pounds with ease. The reason they're investing so heavily in the Hulk is because they need to be able to carry 120 pounds of armor, weapons, and gear, and that need that's been placed on soldiers has led to 35% of soldiers reporting muscular skeletal injuries. Take it from me, when I came home from my deployment to Iraq, I complained to everyone about my back pain. If you were within the maximum effective range of my voice, you got to hear me say, "My back is killing me from carrying all this body armor. Did I mention it was hot over there? Did somebody say proper PPE? I'm Command Sergeant Major Personal Protective Equipment. It's my job to make sure you're fully protected from your PT belt right down to your green socks, soldier." I'm not a soldier anymore though, so I should be okay, right? Nonsense, Cappy. To someone as petty as me, I'll always make sure that you're tracking and squared away. Huh? Now, where's your ballistic eye pro gloves and your exoskeleton suit? It turns out that the powered suits actually don't work. They were all hype. But there are some actual new upgrades that'll be coming to soldiers. What are the real world new body armor developments that I can start telling soldiers around the base to make sure that they're wearing? Well, that's a great question. I'm wearing all my PPE. I got my eye pro, my fire retardant mitten socks. I've got my... Let's learn about the actual immediate soldier protection systems like the new ballistic combat t-shirt. It represents a 14% reduction in weight from the old system. This combat t-shirt isn't like the old one that they issued me when I was over there. It's not just fireproof. Now it's actually rated to stop high velocity shrapnel and 9mm rounds. This has never been done before. The combat ballistic t-shirt gives you way better mobility and comfort than the old DAPS that it's replacing. Your range of motion is way better now. I can't stress how insane this is. It's a flexible fabric instead of a hard pad. Only gunners wore those pads in the past, and it made you look like a third string quarterback, which I told my coach I would have been happy to be. Didn't have to cut me from the team. This is why the DoD is working on a fabric that can stop 7.62 someday in the future, because it seems like there's some hope there. Okay, so some of these futuristic body armor plans might be hype and some might be promising, but there is one company making cutting edge, top of the line body armor, and that's Spartan Armor Systems. Spartan Armor offers steel and ceramic body armor plates, both built and tested to stop high powered rifle rounds. When I show up to the range, I like to train like I fight. I'm always wearing Spartan Armor plates. Everyone notices and says things like, "Cappy, we think it's awesome you suit up for laser tag, but it's starting to really freak out some of the kids." All jokes aside, you should be training with the highest grade equipment on the market, so click the link in the description and get yourself a set of plates from Spartan Armor Systems. Thank you for watching this episode. Please remember to hit the like button right there below the video. It helps promote our videos across YouTube to a wider audience. I'm your host, Chris Cappy. Task and Purpose out.